In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I use Perplexity AI's Google Chrome extension to significantly increase my productivity when I'm working. We're also going to compare it to ChatGPT and Bing's chatbot as well. So hopping right into it, if we go to perplexity.ai, it'll pull us up to their homepage, which is very similar to any other chatbot. But from here, if we click on Chrome, it'll pull up Chrome's web store. And if you haven't already added it, it will say add to Chrome here. Since I've already added it, it says remove. But you'll click on add to Chrome and it'll pop up with the extension here near the top right. And from here, we can see that you can ask it anything on the internet, this domain, or this page. So I'm going to give you guys three really good use cases of how I'm using Perplexity currently. So first off, we go to this article on Freethink. We can see that it's a decent sized article. And a lot of times I don't even want to skim an article. I don't have time nowadays to read full articles. And we can see if it narrates it to us, it's going to take 3 minutes, 17 seconds to listen to it at 1x playback speed. Even if we were to change it to 2x playback speed, it's still going to take over a minute 30. So the fastest way to really summarize this article and take in all this information would just be to simply ask Perplexity to summarize this article. So this article is about ChatGPT versus AI-enabled Bing, and we can see extremely fast it summarizes this article for us and tells us that this Microsoft's new and AI-enabled Bing search engine model has integrated an AI language model that's more powerful than ChatGPT. The new Bing chatbot refused to write a cover letter, and ChatGPT generated a 270-word cover letter based on the job description. So you can already see there's some major differences in Bing and ChatGPT and even Perplexity. So you guys have to find which tool you guys are going to want to use for your own workflow. Secondly, how I'm using this tool is on Reddit. I think this is one of the best ways to use this tool because we can search the whole domain and find out a bunch of different things. So let's just ask it, how do people like the new Call of Duty game MW2? And from here, it's going to tell us exactly how people are feeling about MW2, and they're going to give us 5 sources about where they got this from. So instead of me having to search, go through forums, kind of find an overall consensus, I can see here that people are enjoying the campaign and the good technical performance, but they criticize the multiplayer for being too similar, but others have enjoyed it. Overall, opinions are mixed. So if we had, let's say, a more finance or a YouTube-related question, let's see how it handles that. So what is the average CPM for a finance channel on YouTube? Which would mean how much people are getting paid per 1,000 views before YouTube's cut is taken. So the average CPM on a finance channel YouTube varies depending on the topic, but it's generally on $15 to $25. However, some videos can get up to $50 or $100 CPM. Other Reddit users have reported CPMs ranging from $2 to $30, and it gives you a bunch of sources here that we can click on and a bunch of related, questions that we can ask. And we can ask, let's say, how much do YouTubers make per view? And that's going to pull up Perplexity here on the side. And it'll tell you YouTubers make an average 18 cents per view or $18 per 1,000 views. So it's really awesome if you guys want to deep dive into Reddit rather than having to go through search through all the forums. It's just awesome to be able to click this and get an answer through the domain. So let's find out if we're just asking it on the internet, what is Perplexity and how does it differ? How does it differ from ChatGPT? So let's see what answer it gives us here. It's an answer engine that delivers accurate answers to complex questions. ChatGPT, on the other hand, is a chat tool with similar capabilities to a search engine. While they're both powered by GPT-3, they have different strengths and weaknesses. Exactly. So both of these tools are going to be extremely useful, but you have to find out which one you're going to use for which topics. So let's find out if Perplexity is able to summarize my whole YouTube video. So I have one of my videos here pulled up, and if we go ahead and click on plus, go to this page and say summarize this video. Let's see what is outputted and see if it's able to summarize this video. It says there's several AI powered tools that can summarize YouTube videos, such as Summarize Tech, WordTune, Jasper AI, and YouTube Summarizer. These tools allow users to get a summary of any long YouTube video. So it is unable to do this, but it is giving me ways and telling me different AI tools that I can use to do this. So it's just good to know that this is one of the limitations. It's unable to summarize YouTube videos, but it can obviously summarize articles and do a lot of different things on Reddit. So finally, one of the last ways that I like to use it is on Amazon. So we can search through this domain Let's say recently, and this is one thing I'm actually looking for, is I've been testing out different cameras to upgrade my video quality here on YouTube. So I can say, what is a good camera for a YouTuber to buy? And instead of having to ask this question on Google and having to go through a bunch of articles, here it's going to give me the exact source, which I really like, and it gives you all the related questions, and it tells me there's so many good cameras to buy. Some of them include the Sony ZV-1, iShare 4K digital camera, and Acoleti 4K digital camera. The best camera to spend for a YouTuber depends on their specific needs and budget. So let's say I had to follow up with that and said, what is the best camera for $300 and under for a YouTuber? Let's see if it can narrow this down to even the budget. And it does it right here amazingly. This is really impressive. So it says there are several cameras available for under $300 that would be suitable for a YouTuber. Some options include digital camera for photography, vlogging camera 4K with Wi-Fi. It's important to consider factors such as video quality, audio quality, and ease of use when selecting a camera. And it gives you their different sources here. I hope you guys are able to use Perplexity AI in your day-to-day workflow to boost your productivity. If you guys made it to the end, consider liking, commenting, and subscribing for more. Thanks.